Hi everybody, welcome. We hope you're well. We've got something special for you today. It's Bbtv Cribs. We're in Cheshire at Kerry Kayes' house. Kerry is the former bodybuilding champion of Britain. He's also a specialist in nutrition. He helps a lot of fighters with that side of things. He's also a well-known cutsman and all-round good guy at boxing. He's kindly invited us into his beautiful property today to have a look around. So let's go meet him.
Hi, I'm Kerry Kayes. Welcome to my crib. Come on in, I'll show you around.
Well, Kerry, we're over here in Cheshire. What a beautiful day for it.
Isn't it? I arranged the sun for you.
Well, I appreciate that. We're going to have a little look around your house. Thanks for letting us come in and see everything. And we're going to start in the garage. I can see some brilliant memorabilia here.
Okie doke.
So tell us about some of these, Kerry. You've certainly put some work into framing some of these memories.
Well, you know, I had so much stuff in my old house. And when we moved in and we had all the room, I made a massive effort to get, you know, stuff that hopefully I'll leave my kids, my grandkids, and great memories, you know, great memories.
Yeah. Anything that really stands out to you, Kerry, like?
Well, the Tony Bellew, David A fights, they do. Obviously, Sam Eggington have worked. Even these, it's daft to say that, and if Eddie or Barry Earn complains, I've took these off the wall at 2 o'clock in the morning after the fight, you know what I mean? So Ricky Hatton, Cleverly Fight. Got to be the best fight everyone,
you know. Big fight that, wasn't it?
Yeah, that used to be me.
You haven't changed a bit, Kerry.
I've changed a lot. And as you can see, my wife's not here, but I'll remind you know the story. My wife won a part in The Terminator and refused to do it. So it's hard to get her on any camera. Well, I was working in Columbus, Ohio for bodybuilding. And I used to work every year. I had to go to the Arnold Classic, which is a big show, in probably the second biggest show in the world. And Arnold comes on stage, I was backstage, and he said, we're going to have a raffle and the winner gets a part in the Terminator movie. You don't have to buy a ticket, it's your seat number. And it was my wife. So they bring my wife on stage and she wins a part in the Terminator. In them days, there was no emails, no mobile phones. The landline rings. Hi, this is Beth, Arnold's secretary. Can I speak to Janet? I said, Jan, quick. Come on, listener. Oh, I'm sorry, no, I'm having the bathroom done that week. I refused him. That was it. And I went, you could have said you're having your bathroom refurbished. They'd have understood. She'd have put the phone down, Arnold's secretary. She's, what do you do with the bathroom? You're having the bathroom done? That's my wife, you know what I mean?
She could have been Sarah Connor.
She could have been, who knows?
The Arnold Classic show. Kerry was in the press box. I was in the audience, and my number, seat number, got drawn out. And then I realised it was, and I was trying to hide. And then I got launched onto, dragged basically onto the stage, which I don't like that. I don't like cameras, so it was pretty scary. And I didn't want to do it. And I thought it was wasted on me because somebody else would have loved to have took the prize, but. So I didn't do it.
I've done a bit for British Cycling as well. a letter when Bradley Wiggins won the Tour de France. That's a letter from British Cycling thanking me. And Sarah Story, I'm doing a seminar there to Sarah Story's team. I've worked down at the SES on selection. Just before they went out to the jungle, the candidates, I used to go down and do a lecture on nutrition and got a letter off them thanking me, which I'm very proud of. I worked in a lot of other sports long before boxing, and it was Billy Graham who approached me. And I've told this story 1,000 times and said, I've got a young kid that I think's going to be good, but he's bad at his weight. Can you help me with him? And he's called Ricky Hatton. And it was the hardest, biggest job I've ever took on. This is the pool. Turn it off. Jacuzzi. I have that switched off. That's my cold plunge. So I actually go in there, it's freezing, and then jump in the pool. I think it's good for circulation. So, and then here. I get up every morning. I have a range of exercises for my lower back. I then come in the pool, have a swim, and then I have a red light therapy for my muscles.
What's a red light therapy?
Well, I'm going to show it you. Proud of selling it. As I said, every morning I do a set of exercises for my lower back. It's not like me to mention my bad back, is it? I then have a swim, and then I have this red light therapy, which I brought this in from America. Changing room for the pool.
I can honestly say I've never seen one of these in my life.
Yeah, look it up, J-O-O-V-V.
Right. And does it do? Tell us about it.
Well, light gives energy to the world. If you put a plant in a room with no light, it won't grow. So this is what you call red light therapy, a certain wavelength, and it's very, very good for all your cells.
Wow.
Muscle soreness, everything.
Where'd you get that from?
I got it from America. And there's a lot, Harvard research on it, there's a lot of scientific research.
I was going to say, but
there are some cheap red light equipment, you've got to look into the quality of them. That's why I brought it in from America. Well, I'm 71, I need all the help I can get. And then from the red light therapy, to the bar.
You've got a well-stocked bar here, Kerry. You're not a big drinker though, are you?
I never used to be, but I'm being dead honest with you. Me and my Jan now, we're very, very close, and we've no kids, we're not skint, so we kind of go out 4, 5, 6 nights a week for a meal, and we'll end up having a bottle of wine.
Yeah, yeah.
So, but I mean, you know, I'm a massive believer 80-20. 80 good and 20% do what you want.
That's quite a big bottle of vodka there, though.
Well, if you notice, though, it's full. That's the important thing. It's when they're empty.
Yeah, we'll come back in a week and it'll be empty.
Right, so, well, you guys have been here on fight nights. If I'm not working a fight and it happens to be a decent fight, then we'll get a good few friends, Richard, we'll get him down. I met you guys through Richard, so I thank him for that. And we'll have a boxing night. Savannah's been here for you lads, you know. Yeah, so what do we do? So first of all, put the cinema on. It all has to come out. Oh, it takes about 2 minutes. Not sure what I'm allowed to put on.
So is this where you watch the latest BBTV videos?
Absolutely. So to be honest, this is criminal, this, because we never ever use this room. You know what I mean? But I've got...
Lovely room.
But there's a few things that are quite unique. This is a one-off. This was made by the press for the Vegas fights, and it never went on general sale, and it was just given to the team, and it's basically loads of the photographs of the press in Vegas and loads of different fights.
There's quite a few of the rooms. Yeah. Do you use this room? It's
a nice Christmas room. Day. Christmas Day. This is my Christmas Day room.
Yeah. Lovely.
This is my Christmas Day room.
Oh, you collect walking sticks?
Yeah, it was just somewhere, I don't know. I bought one in a second-hand shop, and then the kids bought me one, and you know, all of a sudden.
Yeah. You which is your favourite walking stick?
This one, mate. Nice. That one.
Yeah, watch out.
That one. This is no big deal here, but this is my little office where I put all my fights and my dates. So, I just have all my fights.
Yeah.
You know, when somebody asks me for a fight, Newcastle, Matt Hatton.
Yeah. What's the next one you're at, Kerry?
Newcastle, Saturday night.
Yeah, Saturday night for the Ritzenville, yeah.
This is me legal paperwork for my court case.
Yeah, don't get that on the camera. Great, and then you know what everyone's going to want to know? They're going to want to see the kitchen and what Kerry Kayes has in his fridge.
I've got nothing in my fridge. We're really low. To be honest, this is where we spend most of our time relaxing.
Yeah.
And watch a bit of telly in here. This is our relaxing room. But as I said, I'm always running around till about 8 o'clock at night.
There's a lovely breeze coming through here, Kerry, because the kitchen leads on to this beautiful scenery outside. But here's where the master of nutrition, would that be reflected in your kitchen? The fact that you're the master of nutrition?
No, that's for the kids, grandkids. We're actually low, we're actually going.
I mean, there really isn't much in there. It's
empty.
You go out for meals.
It's empty. This is where I put all my energy into nutrition. This is where I put all my energy into nutrition.
Yes, the supplements. Well,
yeah. I'm a big supplement man. I'm a big supplement.
Success, Kerry, come from your company.
Yeah, but a lot of people don't. It depends what you like. If you enjoy cooking, look at Josh Warrington's dad, Sean. He loves cooking.
Yeah.
If I want a healthy meal, I don't want to spend hours on it. And I'll be honest with you, a little tip for your people, and I'm getting nothing out of this. Heinz soups, you could spend 2 hours making a soup, and Heinz soup have got no preservatives and no colours. That's as good as your mum makes. And in that one can is two of your five a day. And what I'll do, I'll put a chicken breast in it, and I'll put 240 grams of frozen veg in it, and I'll get me full five a day in one snack. Mm. They're as good as it gets.
And they come in 52 varieties.
Yeah.
Good tip.
And that's my life. I mean, as you probably know, I'm a big family man. I love my kids, I love my wife, and them two there, one's 39, one's 40 now, and it's just my life. All my kids, I'm just big into my family.
Yeah, you're a massive family man, aren't you, Kerry?
Yeah, I'm big into my family.
Is it nice for them as well to have like a base like this where they can come and enjoy?
Well, the grandkids love it, don't they? Yeah. You know, can imagine at school saying, I'm going to my granddad's to swim. You know,
and then look at this. Now, some people, I barely got my own garden. Kerry's got his own lake here. So tell us a little bit about this. Is this one of the things that really sold the property to you?
This view, I walked in, I thought, I'm having it. That's Mere Golf Club. And I think there's about 15 or 16 houses on the lake. And I've got the bottom one. If you wanna go down, guys, I'll show you down the bottom, the dock.
So do you often have a little amble out here, and it's the sun's like this?
Aki, I'm a very lucky man. I was brought up on a council house estate in Gorton. Before that, I was brought up in the slums of Gorton. The houses were that bad, they eventually knocked them down. The first inside toilet I ever saw, I was 14 year old. So, you know, I don't, I don't take any of this for granted.
Yeah. And there's the golf clubs right opposite.
That's the golf. You can see them now. They're on the driving range. And I don't play golf.
You go out in the boat?
Yeah. You know, I've not been out this summer, but yeah, I got a little kayak here.
Look at this.
Each house leaves a bit of land and you can walk all the way around to the golf club if you want. You know, I can honestly remember not getting Christmas presents, not getting birthday presents. I can remember going to bed hungry. We didn't have blankets. We had, in them days, you had army coats. The first inside toilet I ever experienced, I was 14 years old. So I've been brought up in poverty and I'm very proud of what I've achieved. When I like something, I just dive in with both feet and do a million mile an hour at it. And I might not be as efficient as most, but I'm prepared to spend twice the time to get there. I think that's the important thing. Carl came here, Carl Frampton and Jack Catterall, and you know they do open swimming. And Jack and Carl are, well, not spoke now Carl, but Jack wants to come down here and swim it. And you know, it's really bad because I'm not into fishing, but apparently the fish in here are incredible because they've been left alone. Nobody fishes it, you know what I mean? Yeah.
I know it's a little, is that a little conservatory?
Yeah, I'll show you.
So was all this here when you bought the property, Kerry?
Most of it, I've probably added about 10%. Yeah. I've probably added about 10%.
Is this pretty heavy tea, yeah?
Sometimes. Every other Saturday, they have massive firework displays in the May Golf Club and at Christmas. So me and Jan sit down here and watch these fantastic displays of fireworks.
Yeah.
You know, this is Graeme Souness's old house.
I did not know.
Yeah, this is Graeme Souness's old house. I didn't buy it off Souness. He sold it to someone who I bought it off.
The grass is perfectly mown. Now, do you get on one of those little mowers?
No.
Does it?
Listen, shout out to Nat and Dave. They've got two great gardeners.
Looks like a football pitch, about to say that, yeah. And then we've got a lovely little area out here. I never even saw this from the house.
The barbie.
Yeah.
So we have used this, me and Jan. So proper barbecue, extraction fan. What can I say? It's even got its own even got its own dishwasher. So you got everything, look. Everything.
Kerry, do you enjoy hosting people and having people around? Like, do you enjoy that side of thing? You're quite a social person.
We never have a party, but we'll have a boxing party. As you know, you've been to everyone, haven't you?
Yeah,
as you know. As you know, I'm very close to my family, and me and Jan are very close. So I've got the lovely luxury of saying to my wife, I'm going away boxing. And then she'll phone the girls up. I've got three daughters and a son, and they'll all come and stay. And so it's a family get together without dad, because I'm boxing. So it works great for all of us. And
the bar.
Another one. Another one. No, we had this put in. We had this put in because I thought, you know what I mean? Look at this, you know what I mean? If it was a pub who had this outside, you'd go to it, wouldn't you?
Oh, 100%.
Well, do you want to, if we're showing off, do you want to see the view that I wake up to every morning?
Yeah.
Come on then.
Of course.
But no matter what you've got, whenever you get it, the birds will still shit on your path.
There's some philosophy in that.
You'll still get shit on. Not, not sure if somebody said, my wife became an official state pensioner on the 4th of June. She gets a pension. She gets a pension, my wife. So this is the view I wake up to every morning. So I'll show you some more memorabilia. Yeah.
Check this bathroom out. How often do you clean the chandelier?
Once a year. You know, believe it or not, there's a special spray that you get for chandeliers.
I did not know that.
And you put a cloth on the floor, because you spray the chandelier and the particular liquid in the spray picks up the dust and drops off. Wow. You know, somebody invents something for everything.
You didn't get Del and Rodney to do it.
Yeah, exactly. Again, memorabilia. I've just got that much stuff.
Yeah.
Macklin, hey?
Well, you were involved in the fight, the British title Macklin. Fight between Matthew Macklin and Jamie Moore.
I know, but I was in Macklin's card.
I know you were.
Can you believe it?
But what a fight. That still to this day is my favourite overall British fight, I think.
Definitely one you can watch a few times, that one.
I've got, I don't know, what have we got here? Look, Ricky Hatton stuff.
What Ricky Hatton stuff? Okay, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Golden Boy, so that must have been in Vegas.
Yeah.
Just when you was talking to Golden Boy when you was on his private jet, how did that come about?
They got us a private jet each. They got a private jet for Mayweather, and they got a private jet for Ricky. We flew into LA, and we only went to Michigan. Could have drove it.
Yeah, it's a private jet, isn't it?
Oh no, went to New York as well. Went to New York as well. So. My young lady, and we had that done in Spain in 2004, is it? Oh no, 84. This is the first house we looked at, and I walked in and thought, I've got to have it. And I never viewed a single other house, which is the house we lived in Denton. We lived there for 33 years, and I knew about Mayside Road, and I found one was for sale, and I walked in. And I put an offer in the same day, and I never even looked at another house, which is, if you think about it, after 33 years, you should really look at two or three houses, shouldn't you? But I didn't, I dived in with both feet like I always do. Thanks for coming to my crib. I hope you enjoyed it. Please watch it on Bbtv, and I'll see you at the next fight night, lads. Thank you.
See ya.
Hi, I'm Savannah Marshall, WBO World Champion. Welcome to my club.